Adam B., it's main event time and the stakes are high. Benjamin Tull on one side, the black singlet, the navy blue pants on the flip side, Stu Grayson, the black and purple trunks. This is a contest between two of Le Zerosette's undefeated competitors, and right now it's looking like Benjamin Tull might remain that way.
The first show, Stu Grayson defeated Johnny James Irvine and Ray St. John. The second show, he defeated Sheldon Jean. Benjamin Tull in the first show defeated Matt Angel. Last show defeated Psycho Mike. Like you said, Twiggy, one of these two competitors walking out with a blemish on their record.
They're used to beating their opponents, and right now they're beating the heck out of each other. Benjamin Tull goes right to the eyes. You can feel the energy in the room. It's main event time. Things just change. It's like the audience turns on a switch, and things get a lot more ravenous. Things get a lot more rabid. Things get more excitable. And this crowd tonight, they do not like Benjamin Tull.
Stu Grayson walked down to the ring like only he can do. Benjamin Tull not intimidated at all by the power walk to the ring of Stu Grayson.
Grayson looks like he's in the best shape I've ever seen him in. He's shredded. It looks like he got great cheese on those abs. You ready for nachos?
We'll have to send a picture to Benjamin Tull.
He won't like that. And he didn't like that chop that Grayson just annihilated him with. It looks like he's going to return the favor. And he does. That one sends Grayson reeling. Now, even though we have the size differential, both men are strong. They are full of force. But when you get chopped like you do by a man with the hands of the size that Benjamin Tull has, you feel it. But it doesn't seem like it's stopping Grayson, who catches him with that Hurricane Rana moments ago.
Stu Grayson just returned from a vacation in Cuba. I asked him, how was your vacation? He said it was terrible. I had nobody to fight out there.
Well, on the flip side, Benjamin Tull's been fighting people his whole life. This guy, I got nothing but the utmost respect for him. He's been grinding year after year. Again, another veteran, 16, 17 years in the professional wrestling industry. He's finally getting the due he deserves, and he's gonna try to capitalize on all that momentum with a win tonight as he jumps over Stu Grayson, but he gets caught with a dropkick for his measure, and Stu has got the fans on fire here.
And look at that look on the face of Grayson.
Adam, I'm gonna ask you one more time, who do you have money on? Knowing you, you probably took a bet on each man. You end up even Steven at the end as Grayson attempts a springboard. Great ring awareness there, stops himself. Just enough time for Tull to gain some type of advantage. And you'll notice, not sure if the cameras caught it there, but Tull took Grayson from one corner of the apron all the way to the other. He didn't slam him into the turnbuckle or the connector. He sent him chest to post, and that's going to take a lot out of any man.
That's what you got to do against a guy like Grayson. You got to bring the fight. You can't get intimidated. You have to go right at the man, and you got to throw whatever you have at him in tenfold.
Well, that's what both of these men have been doing since the opening bell here. It's been back and forth, and this match is not even 5 minutes old. These fans, I've said it once, I'll say it again, they do not like Tull. But the thing that's impressed me most about him over the past few months is how little he lets it affect him. He stays on point. He punishes his opponents, whether it's been Matt Angel or Mike Rollins, and right now it's Stu Grayson, who's tasting the same type of medicine he's been dishing out for months on end.
Grayson trying to get back to his feet. Benjamin Tull all over him. Not too often you see Stu Grayson in such rough shape.
Benjamin Tull just punishing him. Stu, you can see it right there. It's clear as day, using the ropes to pull himself up to stay in this fight. And that's what it's really broken down to early on, a fight. Benjamin Tull breaking out in one of those trademark sweats. Big shot to the breadbasket there. It looks like we're gonna see a back suplex. Stu flips out of it.
Big power!
The Uranagi sends the big man down, kicks him right in the face, hits the ropes. Acai moonsault, center of the ring. That's gonna be good for a one, two. This one was almost over.
You gotta pin Benjamin Tull better than that.
Well, he almost had him. If he stays on him, Stu might have a chance of remaining undefeated here at Le Zerosette. Now, unlike contests we've seen earlier tonight, whether it be Ray St. Jean and Dash Bison, or more recently, we saw that very, very, very long contest between Channing Decker and James Stone. This one, to me, doesn't have the makings for one of these epics. It looks like it could end at any moment just because of the physicality that both of these men are dishing out.
Two of the elite athletes in Quebec wrestling, Benjamin Tull and Stu Grayson, putting on a hell of a main event so far.
Well, here's the thing, Adam. You've been around wrestling for many, many years now. The longer this match goes on, who does that favor, in your opinion?
Well, I'd have to say, I mean, Benjamin Tull, the bigger competitor, he's going to start gasping for a win pretty soon. I mean, this guy's athletic, but he's a bigger guy, Stu Grayson, in such amazing shape.
Well, there's no doubt about that. The thing that I've remarked about Tull is how much he's able to slow the match down. He will find a way, whether it's hook or crook, to bring his opponent down to his level, keeping things at a slug's pace, staying in control. Look at that. He might be conning Stu in here. He's just been playing dead weight. Look at that, and I'm exactly right. He manages to sucker Stu in, and he catches him with an elbow in the neck and ear area. Just enough to stun Stu. Look at that, he's reeling. It goes back to check. I don't know how much this whip is going to work, which it doesn't. Tall holding on. Look at that, just rocks him with that huge strike. Stu ducks the boot, kicks up out of it, catches him with that Pele kick. I think we can see we had a great vantage point here. Tull's eyes just rolling to the back of his head.
No!
Look at that!
Drops him down at him.
Just a pancake there.
Bert.
He's serving up pancakes tonight in Gatineau. No maple syrup, they're dry as hell. Pancake fan, Adam?
No, I'm a crepe guy.
All right, more of a crepe guy. Action at a standstill here. We're over here talking about pancakes and crepes. The only thing these guys are serving up is blows and strikes and slams and smashes, as we can see right here.
Back again with these just.
Now this is gonna be a statement match for one of these two men. There's no title on the line, but there's bragging rights. And when it comes to in-ring competition, sometimes that means just as much as carrying around a piece of leather with 10 pounds of gold on it. Because forever after this moment, one of these men is gonna be able to walk around and say, yeah, you know what, we were both undefeated. They had lost, I had lost, but on that night I beat him. And it's always gonna be on his record. And it looks like Stu might be the man to end Benjamin Tull's undefeated streak here, and Tull surprisingly on his feet after that springboard DDT. Stu looking to take to the sky. What's this gonna be, Adam?
Oh, no, gets caught. Grayson took the air out of Tull, landed the DDT, couldn't hit the dive, and now it's Tull back in the driver's seat.
And you'll remember, this is the second time that Tull has gone back to that post as the advantage. Earlier on, he threw Stu Grayson into the post from the apron. This time he charges him in, catches him with the boot, and it's only good for a two, and I can't believe it, and neither can these fans.
Benjamin Tull, just such an effective marksman with those boots.
You can see it on the face of Tully. He's talking to himself in there. Now this, I've said it all night. I call this type of behavior into question. If you're gonna take a break, get your air, that's fine. But you know the fans aren't on your side. What's the point of instigating them, even just allowing the possibility of letting them get into your head when you're taking on such a skilled opponent like Stu Grayson is?
Now could be time for dinner.
He's looking for that sit-out Death Valley driver. Stu creeps out of it. Goes for a pinfall attempt.
Oh, lands the knee.
I think you can see spit just fly out of Tull's face. He's got him set up once again. Stu counters. What the hell is this? Just slides behind. It looks like it's a swinging neck breaker of some sort.
Whoa.
That was about as close as it's going to get.
Stu spiked Tull, but not enough to put Big Benji away.
The fans are firmly behind Grayson here, the man that is born and bred for combat. He is showing that that is nothing but the utmost truth here tonight in Gatineau. As he just, look at that, smart ring awareness. He knew he had an angle to take Grayson into the corner. He's been using that to his advantage. He's been quietly working on the midsection in the back of Stu. And when it comes down to it, all of that area is connected. You have your organs on the inside. You attack the ribs. It hurts your spine. It hurts everything. I got to call this into question, though. Not a smart move for a man who's sucking wind. Swings him out into a big swinging slam for one, two. It's not enough.
Had all of his weight down on Stu Grayson, but Grayson still fights on.
Tull can't believe it. This is, looks to be the first time tonight that Tull has been at a loss here. This is one of the many occasions tonight that we've seen the bigger men going to the top rope. I think at the point that we're at now in pro wrestling, a lot of the bigger guys know they need to adapt, or they become like the dinosaurs. They die off. This is the thing. Because they're so new at scaling the ropes, there's a difficulty in adjusting when your opponent pops up like Grayson just did. We saw this happen to Stone earlier tonight.
We have a lot of power to pull this off, but if anybody could, it's Stu Grayson.
Tull fighting out of it with these huge blows to the midsection once again.
Oh,
I think Tull may have blown out his ankle there. I'm not sure. He was slow to get up. He got caught with a running knee strike. Stu sizing him up. Look at this. He's got him up in that burning hammer position. We know what he's going for here.
Bane breaker.
He's taking his time. Is he going to be able to get the big man up and over? And he does.
Oh,
that's got to be all she wrote.
Side,
one,
steal,
two,
delivered
three.
For Stu Grayson.
I mentioned it moments ago. I talked about the danger of the bigger man going to the top rope. Tull got caught off guard. He fought Grayson off. He knocked him off the ropes. And when it was time to try to dive over Grayson, what happened? The big man who's not used to flying off the top rope, he lands ankle first. He may have got caught in a divot in the ring there. And that split second was just enough time for Grayson to capitalize with that devastating knee strike into the Bane Breaker. And right now, we are looking at the only man in Litzango set who is undefeated, and that's Stu Grayson here tonight, Adam.
On top of the mountain in the singles rankings in Loot 07, and Stu Grayson just is dominating competition left and right.
This has been a fiery night of action, Adam. What do you think? The third edition, it's in the books. Who impressed you tonight?
I mean, how can you argue with Stu Grayson? Still undefeated, like you said, Twiggy. Still one of the best competitors you'll find in a wrestling ring.
Stu Grayson among many of the competitors tonight walking out of here with victories. Thank you so much for Adam B. I am Twiggy, and we'll see you next time at the matches.